Hello dear students, in this video I will continue with solving the exercise questions from exercise 21.1 chapter 21 Applied Mathematics by R.D. Sharma. Here I will solve the questions 15 and 16. Here we will see how we can use one sample t-test when the sample data is given. As we have already seen, the t-test statistic, it is given by let x1, x2, up to etc. xn be a random sample of size n from a normal population with mean mu and variance sigma square. Then students t-statistic, it is given by t is equal to x bar minus mu upon capital S by root 10, where x bar is the sample mean, summation I equal to 1 to n xi upon n, and we have s square which is given by 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar the whole square. And now here we have studied in class 11 how to find the variance of sample data. So using that formula, we can find S square as 1 by n minus 1 into summation di square minus 1 by n summation di the whole square, where di equal to xi minus a, where a is the assumed mean. So this is a simpler method to find the variance or to find this summation xi minus x bar the whole square using the assumed mean. So using this formula, we will solve the questions 15 and 16 from exercise 21.1. The 15th question, it is given a random sample of 10 boys had the following IQs: 70, 120, 110, 101, 88, 83, 95, 93, 107 and 100. Do these data support the assumption of a population mean IQs of 100? Given the value of t, the table value of t at 5% level of significance and 9 degrees of freedom is 2.262. So usually in the previous questions, in my previous video I have explained about the previous questions, there the sample mean and the sample standard deviation, or the sample mean and the sum of squares of deviation from the mean, that will be given. Here we are given the sample data. So here the sample of 10 boys had the following IQs. So these are the IQs of 10 boys. Now we have to test whether this sample was drawn from a population with mean IQs of 100. So the first step is the null hypothesis H naught. It is the population mean is 100, and the alternate hypothesis H1 will be the population mean is not equal to 100. And the test statistic is given by t equal to x bar minus mu upon s by root n. Here we have n as 10 and mu is equal to 100. We need to find x bar and s. Now this let us find using the variance formula. So here the various xi's are given. So the values are 70, 120, 110, 101, 88, 83, 95, 93, then 107 and 100. First let us find x bar and see whether we can directly use this formula to find x bar and s square. So s square equal to 1 by n minus 1 summation xi minus x bar the whole square. So when we add all these, when we add all these, we get 967. So x bar will be 1 by n summation xi. So it is 967 upon 10, which is 96.7. Here if we find xi minus x bar, then we will have different fractions included here. So it will become difficult to find the square. So we can use the formula s square equal to 1 by n minus 1 summation di square minus 1 by n summation di the whole square, where di equal to xi minus, here let us take the assumed mean as 90, xi minus 90. So here di equal to xi minus 90, and here we have di square. So 70 minus 90 is minus 20, 120 minus 90 30, 110 minus 90 20, then 101 minus 90 11, 88 minus 90 minus 4, 83 minus 90 minus 7, 95 minus 95, 93 minus 93, 107 minus 90 is 17, 100 minus 90 is 10. Now when we add all these, we get summation di as 67. And now finding di square. Di square will be here for the first data minus 20 the whole square. So it is 400. Next 30 square 900, 20 square again 400. 11 square 121, 2 square 4, 7 square 14, I'm sorry, 7 square 49, 5 square 25, 3 square 9, 17 square 289, 10 square is 100. Now summation di square. Now when we add all these, we get 2297. So we can find s square as 1 by 10 minus 1 into summation di square. Di square is 2297 minus 1 by 10 into summation di the whole square. So 67 the whole square. So this is equal to 1 by 9 into 2297 minus 67 square is 4489. Divided by 10 will be 448.9. So this is equal to 1848.1 upon 9. So it is 205.34. Now we can calculate t. And from here s is equal to root of 205.34. So root of 205.34, let us keep it as it is. T is equal to x bar minus mu divided by s by root 10. So x bar, here we got x bar as 96.7 minus 100 divided by root of 205.34 upon root 10. So this is equal to minus 3.3 upon root of 20.534. Root of 205.34 upon root 10, the whole root can be taken. So we get root of 20.534. This is equal to minus 3.3 upon 4.53, which is minus 0.73. So we get the t value as minus 0.73. T equal to minus 0.73. Now we have the next step. So mod t equal to 0.73. Step 3 is we have to compare the calculated value of t with the tabulated value. The table value is 2.262. Therefore mod t less than tabulated value at 5% level of significance. So the null hypothesis is accepted at 5% level of significance. Hence, the data support the assumption of a population mean IQs of 100. So here it is asked, do these data support the assumption of a population mean IQs of 100? So the answer is yes, the data supports the assumption of a population mean IQs of 100. So this is how we have to go about when the sample data is given.